What I hope to do in this video is several examples from the Khan Academy exercise on negative number addition and subtraction equivalent expressions. And this is just to really make sure that we fully digested how we can compute with negative and positive numbers, and also the properties that the properties of arithmetic that we can apply when we compute with them. So let's get started. So it says Raoul tried to evaluate an expression step by step. All right, so they start with the expression, they give us the steps. And then they say, find Raoul's mistake. And we have step one, step two, step three, or maybe Raoul did not make a mistake. And like always, I encourage you to pause the video and try to solve it on your own before I work through it. All right, so let's look at this first step. It says 3 minus negative 5 minus 7. And it looks like he correctly recognized that subtracting a negative 5 is the same thing as adding a positive 5. So he replaced the minus negative 5 with the plus 5 right over there. So that seems right. All right, so step one seems all right. Then what does he do next? So he has two options. He could say 3 plus 5 is equal to 8, and then subtract 7 from that, and he would get 1. Or he could even say 5 minus 7 is negative 2, and then add that to 3 and get 1. And it looks like Raoul tried to go that second way, but he made a slight mistake, because he said 5 minus 7 is equal to 2, not negative 2. 5 minus 7 should be negative 2, but he wrote a positive 2 right over here. So his mistake is in step 2. And then obviously step 3 becomes wrong because of step 2. But this is where he first makes the mistake. Let's do several more of these. Which of the following expressions are equivalent to 6 plus negative 4 minus 5. All right, so let's look at all the options here. So this first one, let's see, it has a negative 5. Well, the negative 5, this minus 5, if you put it out front, you could represent it as a negative 5. Then it has a negative 4 here. And here we're adding a negative 4. So, or I guess you could say we have negative 5, we have minus 4 here, which is the same thing as adding a negative 4. So that seems reasonable. And then you have plus 6, and you just had a positive 6 right over here. So this one actually seems equivalent. It's just the order. They just switched the order. Instead of adding the 6 first, they add the positive 6 last. Instead of having the minus 5 at the end, they put a negative 5 in the beginning. And instead of saying adding negative 4, they just said minus 4. But these are all equivalent. So this one is going to be an equivalent expression. Now let's see. This one has... So it has the 6 and the minus 4, they just changed the order, but now it has positive 5. And that's not going to work because we're subtracting 5 out here. So if we want to put the 5 out front, it needs to be a negative 5. So this isn't going to be right. And I'm not going to select none of the above because I found a choice that is equivalent. Let's keep going. It's a lot of fun. Which of the following expressions are equivalent to negative 4 plus 4 plus 5 in parentheses? So if I were to compute this, I would say negative 4 plus, and I would add the 4 and the 5 first, and I would get 9. So it would be negative 4 plus 9, which is equal to 5. So let's see, 0 plus 5, well, that's going to be equal to 5. So that's equivalent. I mean, I could just do it again. Negative 4 plus 9, negative 4 plus 9 is 5. It's the same thing as 9 minus 4. And this right here is 5. Now this is negative 4 minus 4, which would be negative 8. And then plus 5 would be negative 3. So that's not equivalent. In order to be equivalent, this should evaluate out to be 5. So I'm not going to select that. And I'm not going to select none of the above because I already found a choice that I like. Let's do a few more of these. So once again, which are equivalent? Negative 5 plus 7 minus negative 3. So here you have negative 5 plus 7 plus 3. Well, that makes sense. If you subtract a negative 3, that's the same thing as adding a 3. And they didn't change the negative 5 plus 7. They didn't change the negative 5 plus 7. So I'll definitely select this one. Definitely select that. Now let's look at this one. So negative 5 here, they're subtracting a 5. So that seems reasonable. Adding 7, they're adding 7. Here they're subtracting a negative 3, which is the same thing as adding a positive 3. Here they just have a negative 3 here. If this was a positive 3, then we'd be in business. But this is a negative 3, so this isn't going to work. So I will not select that. And I won't select none of the above because I found a choice. Let's do one more of these. Which of the following expressions are equivalent to x plus y, and since there are parentheses around it, I would do that first. And then I would subtract z, select all that apply. All right, so here they have z plus x plus y. So they have the x plus y part, but then they have a positive z, or they have a z here, while over here they have minus z. So if they wrote a negative z here, this and this would have been equivalent, but they don't have a negative z here. So I would not select that one. Now this one, you have x plus y minus z. Well, this, they just changed the parentheses. Instead of doing the x plus y first, they're doing the y minus z first. And this is, you know, this goes back to addition and subtraction. You have the associative property. You could associate these, you could start with these, adding these two first, and then you do the subtraction. Or you could do the subtraction first, and then you add this one. And if you don't believe me, you could try it out with some numbers, and I encourage you to try it out with some negative numbers. But it will indeed all work out. All they did is they changed where the parentheses are. They did the y minus z first, and then they do the y minus z, and then they add it to the x, as opposed to doing the x plus y first, and then subtracting the z. So I would go with that one.